Be slow to dismiss those crossroad moments in life when you get the opportunity to change direction. The future is not female. Globally, it's quite obvious that women have fewer opportunities than their male counterparts with regards to access to basic higher education, healthcare, jobs, economic participation, political representation, and so on. This gender gap has led to numerous campaigns for the emancipation of the girl child. However, inasmuch as the fight is commendable, focusing on a particular sex may not augur well for us in the long run. What do I mean? Permit me to go on a road less traveled. And since I am so good a storyteller, I'd like to tell you of my once upon a time visit to the Nigerian prison, or the Nigerian Correctional Center as it's now being called. The visits that changed my perspective on gender balance and the world's approach to gender equity. What was supposed to be a harmless visit to inmates, lending a legal listening ear and ascertaining their general well-being, turned a mind shift which I believe should be a topic to be talked about at tables. As expected, I, being a female advocate, interacted only with the female inmates, and when I was done, with exhaustion, my eyes accidentally glanced up the notice board at the waiting area. I will leave the fact of the total capacity of that particular prison being at 250 and the total number of inmates recorded at 840 as a topic for another discussion. What really caused an alarm in my mind's eye was the fact that the total number of male inmates were recorded at 824, as against that of females recorded at 16. I would now leave you to do the ratio. This brings me to my advocacy today. For once, let us approach this issue of gender equality from a different perspective. If our measures for gender balance are limited to girl child empowerment programs and women freedom conferences, then I'm afraid that our strategy might be skewed and unsustainable, because it clearly begs the question: how far would we go on this path before we realize that attention needs to be given to the male child also? Is it not obvious that the average male child from a tender age is already laden with so much responsibility of being a man, and yet so little guidance or mentorship is given as to how? This shocking neglect is handed down from one generation to another. Little wonder the just stated statistics. The zero focus and moral standards demanded from our men have led to crime rates being 98% male dominant, more dysfunctional marriages plagued by domestic violence and abuse meted out by the same men, more mentally deranged men forcing marriages on underage girls, and even the unwell fathers trading their daughters to men their age. I can go on and on. In truth, I am a girl advocate, and I say with every certainty that the girl child will never be free if education is centered on us alone, while the ones we shield ourselves from seek to scorn the girl activists. The future, I say, is not female. The future is both sexes.
Yeah, I want to a bit disagree with you, because maybe if both male and female in that correctional facility had been 824, you probably would have felt okay. Because the society we live in, the focus had been too much on the man, the boy child, that you need to first and foremost elevate the girl child mentality of training the girl child to the level, at least a bit, to where the man child is. That patriarchal society that we live in. So that people will understand. Take for example, if you're a girl now, and I of course, a man, as a girl, we go for an interview. The first question would be, madam, hope you won't get pregnant very soon. You know, for some organizations. So nobody will ask me whether I hope I won't get married very soon. And so for that kind of society, the attention, the focus mainly is on the man child. So let us also elevate the girl child to that level. But also, where I now share the same view with you is, yes, if you want to train only the queen, you also need to train the king. Otherwise, you will have the slave marry the queen. I agree with you on that level. But that does not mean that we should in focusing, we need extra care on the girl child, the society we are in now. Otherwise, if you now say, let us make them equal, they will never be at par. What basically is playing out.
But liberals, is there a problem with equality?
No.
So you're saying
the imbalance, the balance is so much. The gap is 1,000
that you want to improve the woman first.
But
you can't abandon the man.
No, I'm not saying abandon.
No, you will, when you concentrate too much on the girl.
There's no even concentration. It's just a drop in the ocean. Naturally, what you have now is like what 1,000 to 10. And so what I am saying is that natural default, the natural setting is the male child, the male child. And so, also let there be that conscious effort to also raise the girl child. Until you get to a situation where you have 1,500, then we can now begin to talk about the challenges and or on just focusing
sure,
on the
I'm
girl
sure
child.
I'm sure Uche has a very it's different. Yeah, I'm positive. I can see it.
I'm just actually listening because, I mean, I understand where Sandra is coming from, you know, but I do feel somehow this advocacy is not necessarily quite for Nigeria per se. Like, I think it might be for more of a Western
nation. But it's Nigeria.
Because as we're dealing with Nigeria here, I do agree with liberals that I think there's still, you know, we have to bring the girl child up because it's still a very patriarchal society. But if we're talking about in the West, it's getting to the point now where those sort of statistics you were saying, I was actually surprised. I was thinking that's more like now in the West, like especially in America, like, you know, in the black areas in America and everything where, you know, they now don't have any real regard for the male child or men. Everything is really anti-men, anti-this, you know, that sort of rhetoric that's been spewed all over the place.
But she's living, she just gave us a living statistic.
I know, but I don't know.
Right now.
Okay, so you were talking about the Western, you were talking about the Western.
As in, that's what resonated with me when you.
This is at
now.
October.
Thank you.
2019. Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, I have the facts or the total number of prison inmates. The total number of prison inmates as at October 2019 is at 74,000 thereabouts. While the total number of male out of that 74,000 is 72,699.
Let me also shock you that if a man and a woman commit the same crime, the likelihood that the woman get bail first before the man is also very
which
high.
Which brings me to my advocacy.
That's why you have some of those imbalances also.
Which brings me to my advocacy, being that you said that there is so much focus on the male species.
Yeah,
I disagree, being that for me, I think that there is so much focus on the female species than the male. This is my reason. You see, when you go online and check for women empowerment program, you see thousands of women empowerment programs. You see thousands of conferences being hosted for females alone.
Yeah.
How many do you see hosted?
We don't have time. Why I'm saying this, you don't know, do you know why you don't have ministry for men affair? Because every ministry is a men affair. So you now, out of 45 ministry, you create one for women affairs. Because in the other ministries, the women don't even, they've not elevated struggle.
So there are two different things here in my perspective. There's a political power, empowerment, being involved in decision making. But what she's saying, I think, is more relatable with regards to the consequences, the real life consequences of that we deal with on a day-to-day basis. Yeah. You and I know education in the Southeast, male child is very extremely low compared to women. So we're dealing with a real problem, and I think we need to address. I think her point needs to be. I agree with her. Let's balance it.
Yeah, I agree. 50%, but not completely.
Because her point is to balance it.
Yeah, because now the emphasis is always on the man. So that's why you see all of this emphasis on women springing up everywhere. Defaultly.
I think she's basically ringing the alarm, sounding alarm.
Okay, well, we've told you as we see it. Time for you to tell us how you see it. On Nigerians are all talk and no action, Simon Templer says, again, the advocate has been able to hit the nail on the head. in regards to every appropriate topic for discussion. I agree with the majority of the panel, but disagree with the legal gentleman that would be Liberus, who advised Alhaji Atiku to not go to court. I appeal to your program to please continue this topic. Nigerians cannot wait on God when he has given tools to fix our problems. After all, when God chose David, he didn't sit down waiting to be spoon-fed. He got up and faced Goliath and fought battles. On what's rice got to do with it? Nutriman says, the panel should look at the bigger picture, and we all have to stop this mentality of selling our resources for paper money at every opportunity. Instead, we should use our resources inward, first to augment ourselves in the area of health and environment. The border closure is a good idea and has multifaceted long-term benefits. On par to the people, Oluwajoba Odesanya is cringing at Ekene's use of a London slang and says, why would you say in it on national TV? It's a London slang. Niger can copy. And then he uses the hashtag cringy. Oluwajoba, is cringy not a London slang? Just having fun as we do. Keep your comments coming in on our social media platforms on Facebook, Post TV Africa, hashtag the Advocate NG, or on Twitter and Instagram at Plus TV Africa, hashtag the Advocate NG. To catch up with previous broadcasts, go to www.plustvafrica.com/theadvocate. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel at Plus TV Africa. After the break, Liberus tables his advocacy and lets you be the judge. So let me say in advance, the jury is certainly out on this one.